Okay, so today we're going to be taking a look at expanding single brackets. So basically all that means is we're going to be multiplying all the terms on the outside of the bracket by all the terms on the inside. So let's take a look at a few examples. Okay, for our first example, we have 2, open bracket, a plus 2, close bracket. So that means that I'm going to multiply all the terms inside the bracket by 2. So let's give that a go. We've got 2 multiplied by a, which is 2a. And then I have 2 multiplied by positive 2, which is positive 4, so I'll have plus 4. So the final expression for that expanded bracket will be 2a plus 4. Okay, for the next one, we have 4 multiplied by b. That's going to give us 4 lots of b. And then we've got 4 multiplied by negative 3. So 4 multiplied by negative 3 is negative 12. So I'm going to have minus 12. So the final expression for that one will be 4b minus 12. Okay, for our next question, we have negative 3 multiplied by c, which is negative 3c. And then we have negative 3 multiplied by positive 7, which is negative 21. So I'm going to have a minus 21 here. And that's the answer to that one. Okay, for the next question, I have negative 8 times d, which is negative 8d. Okay, but this time I've got negative 8 multiplied by negative 5. So we've got a negative times a negative, which makes a positive. And our 8 times 5 is 40. So I have negative 8d plus 40. I can also switch this around. So I have the positive first. So we could rewrite this as 40 take away 8d. Okay, for this next question, we've got 7 multiplied by 3x. So 7 times 3 is 21. So we've got 21x. And then we've got 7 multiplied by 5y. 7 times 5 is 35, so we're going to have positive 35 lots of y. Okay, for this next question, we have 4 multiplied by 11x, which is 44x. And then we have 4 multiplied by negative 8y. So 4 multiplied by negative 8 is going to give us negative 32. So here we'd have minus 32 lots of y. Okay, for this next question, we're going to have to expand and simplify 2 single brackets. So we're going to have to expand the brackets like we've just done in the previous questions. Then to simplify, we're going to have to collect the like terms. We actually did this in our last video. So if you want to check that out, I'll leave a link in the description and I'll also leave a card in the top right corner. So feel free to check that out if you wish. Okay, when we have a question like this, where we have 2 single brackets that we have to expand, it can be extremely useful to separate them, just so we don't miscalculate when we expand them. So we're going to have our first expansion here with our 2 and then a plus 3. And then our second expansion is going to be our positive 5 and then a plus 6. So let's expand them. So for this first one, we have 2 multiplied by a, which is 2a. And then we have 2 multiplied by positive 3, which is positive 6. So I'd have plus 6. And then moving over to the blue bracket, we have positive 5 times a, which is positive 5a. So we'd have plus 5a. And then we'd have positive 5 times positive 6, which gives us positive 30. So we'd have plus 30. So that's the expand part of the question done. So now to simplify, all we have to do is collect the like terms. So what have we got? Well, we've got 2a plus 5a, which gives us 7 lots of a. And then we have positive 6 plus another 30. That gives us positive 36. So we would have plus 36. So the final answer to that question would actually be 7a plus 36. Okay, for this next question, we have for our first bracket 3, then x plus 4. And in our second bracket, we have positive 7 and then y plus 2. Okay, so expanding the first bracket, we have 3 multiplied by x, which gives us 3x. We then have 3 multiplied by positive 4, which is positive 12, so plus 12. And then in our second bracket, we have positive 7 times y, which is plus positive 7y plus 7y. And then we have positive 7 times 2, which is positive 14, so plus 14. So now let's collect the like terms. Well, we have 3x as the only x term, so we have 3 lots of x. Then we have 7y, which is the only terms of y, so plus 7y. And then we have our constant terms. We have positive 12, and then plus another 14, which will give us plus 26. So the final expression for that expansion would be 3x plus 7y plus 26. Okay, for our next question, in the first bracket we have 4, then x plus 5. Now this time in the second bracket we have a negative, so we've got negative 3 multiplied by, and then inside the bracket, x plus 4. Okay, so expanding as normal. To start with, we have 4 multiplied by x, which is 4x. Then 4 multiplied by positive 5, which is positive 20. Then in the second bracket, we have negative 3 times x, which is negative 3x. And then we have negative 3 times 4, which is negative 12. Okay, so collecting like terms, we have 4x take away 3x. So 4x take away 3x is 1x, so just x. And then for our constant terms, we have 20, positive 20, take away 12. So 20 take away 12 is positive 8, so we'd have plus 8. So our final expression for this would be x plus 8. And for our final question today, for our first bracket, we have 3x plus 7. And then for our second bracket, we have negative 6, x minus 5. Okay, so expanding the first bracket, we have 3 times x, which is 3x. 3 times positive 7, so it's positive 21. And then in our second bracket, we have negative 6 times x, which is negative 6x. And then we have negative 6 times negative 5, which is actually positive 30. Okay, now to collect these like terms, we have 3x take away 6x. So 3 take away 6 is actually negative 3, so we're going to have negative 3 lots of x. And then for our constant terms, we have plus positive 21, add 30, which gives us positive 51. So we can also turn this expression around. So we have the positive first. So we can write negative 3x plus 51 the other way around as 51 take away 3x. So that's it for today's video. Hopefully you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like. If you've got any questions at all, or if there's any specific topics you'd like me to go over next, then please let me know in the comments. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.